Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, welcome to another edition of the AccessOfTrader.com nightly wrap-up show. Hope everybody is doing well. Hope everybody had a good trading day, some pretty good value today. Again, the theme of the tape, again, nothing really has changed. Again, we talked about this on the weekend video. There's just not going to be a lot of surprises from now till the end of the year. Again, I think thinking outside of the box, trying to put on Q trades, trying to catch a reversal to the upside, to the downside. In theory, you know, it sounds sexy. It's really good. But again, I don't think you'll need to overthink right now. There's literally 2 weeks left in the year. We're in a bull market. Look, do you have bearish tendencies? Absolutely. Like what Roku did on Friday. Look what Roku did today. We'll talk about that in a second. But overall, you have ridiculous amounts of strength. And again, you don't need to search. You got, you know, you could find it right in front of you. You know, when you have a 23-point move on Tesla, okay, after a 40-point move on Tesla, it does show you exactly where the sentiment lies. So trying to reinvent the wheel, especially towards the last couple of weeks of the year, just doesn't make sense. Again, I think take the market at face value. There's nothing going to come out between now, or at least we don't know. There's nothing going to come out between now and December 31st that's going to spook the tape. If there was, it would have been already out there, right? We have China news fast-forwarding phase between one and two. The economic numbers are fine. People have no fear in this tape. There's rotation going on. The key right now in the tape is not, you know, can the market sustain strength into the end of the year? I think it's irrelevant. We've been saying this for months. I think it doesn't make a difference if we sell off 2 weeks straight at the end of the year. Look what we've done. Look what we've done strictly just from October. So the idea of the scoreboard needs to or has to close at the highs of the year. Okay, it sounds great in theory, but it doesn't make a difference. Again, our job is not to chase a Tesla, right? Our job is not to chase a Tesla that's already putting up a $60, $80 move just since, December, right? Just this first week of December, December the 5th, it was where? 327, it's at 380. You know, you're talking about a 60, 70 point move since 11 days, right? 11 days. So my job is not to look at there. You know, I didn't trade Tesla today. I saw this whole move. It was huge. It was ridiculous. Again, there's no safety up here, right? We traded Tesla here. We traded Tesla here. We traded Tesla here. Somewhere right here. Somewhere right here. But again, today just wasn't the day. Look, if you traded it, God bless. Nobody is going to spite you. But right now, we are looking, like we talked about on the weekend video, and every single day, we are looking for value. We're looking for a safety net, defined safety net, that if we enter a position and it just doesn't confirm the proper way, we can get out with very, very limited damage instead of trying to buy Tesla on a sneaky area on a 70-point run, only to see a safety net, well, 60 points lower. So again, the reward to risk is skewed. It's very, very wide. It's going higher. Everybody's joking about the 420 secured, right? It probably does get the 420 just for the irony, right? But again, there's much more value. Now, tomorrow, again, am I going to buy this thing into strength? Absolutely not. There's no chance in hell I will be buying this thing into Tesla. The only value into Tesla tomorrow, if we do get a very light volume wash, right? We get a light volume wash somewhere into the rising support. And if it holds that support, get long against the low of the day. And hopefully that turns into a red to green parabolic move day two. But other than that, again, we are looking for value. If you look at today's session, we got that value, okay? But we didn't get that value coming off high levels, okay? I wasn't talking about, you know, buying something that's up 17 days in a row, 200 points. We were looking for value. And if you go break down the most basic part of what we do, it's all about strategy. It's all about education. It's all about, you know, it's all about simplicity in common sense thinking. Again, it's always about thinking. You can't become a better trader if you don't become a better thinker. And again, our game plan was based on value. So if you look at the day, again, very, very aggressive move Friday on Roku, big reversal. And again, Roku was up $2, right? It was up $2 on the $2 on the open, on the gap, along with anything else. And I said, hey, there's a green to red trade on watch. Note, this is not a pivot, right? Green to red, guys, is not a pivot. It's just momentum. It still needs to build below 132. If it builds 132, it can flush, right? And again, destroy it. I mean, absolutely destroy it. And again, it's nothing to do about chasing stocks. It's all about understanding market sentiment and reading the tape. So here was, you know, here was the 32, right? Here was the 32. I said there was a shot to get the 30. I did not think there was a shot it could get to 27. But again, this is what we talk about aggression, not only about aggression to the downside, to the upside as well. And something I haven't even seen the news, but something broke after the close. But again, here's the 132, right? Here's the 132 pivot, okay? And just got destroyed, just absolutely destroyed. The most, the amazing part about that 132 pivot, there was actually a sneaky pivot, right? And there was a sneaky pivot right here. I think it was 33, I believe, right? I think I talked about 33. All these Google ads, Google and Apple ads. Where was the sneaky pivot? Oh, here it is. Here it is. Yeah, 133 was a sneaky pivot. It was right before it went red. If it builds below, it can flush. That's why I said experience. So anyway, you had a $5 move, really, really aggressive move. TBTH, again, has nothing to do with beta. Charts are charts. Let me just shut this off. It's getting me dizzy. So TBTH had nothing to do with beta. Again, these are just technical, basic technical analysis. TBTH 2220, 2230. If it builds above, it can go. TBTH. Here's your TBT. What's the symbol? TBPH. Okay. TBPH. Right. Here's just a basic technical analysis. Right. Here's 2220, 2230. The stock went to almost 23. I still like it higher. I think there's a shot in the next couple of days. It's going to start going into this upper Bollinger Band. So that was good. Again, I didn't trade that. Nothing to do with this thing. But this thing, I traded. And we traded it perfectly. Mwah! Once in a while, you get a very, very smooth move into measure potential. And this was a beauty. Absolute beauty. We were watching Netflix. And I said, please, God, let me just please go today. Please go today. Let the stocks that haven't rallied catch up. And there's going to be another one we're going to talk about in a few minutes that I think is finally ready. But I said, Netflix, just please, please, let this be the day. Let this be the day. Let this be the day. And we got long right here. Here was the whole 302 area. Okay, here was the whole 302 area right over here. Here's the 302 supply, last week's high. Once it got over 302, I said there's a shot against the 306 and went to as high as the 305.60s. My highest sale was at 304.70. So almost caught a $3 move on my last run. So I was very happy. With Netflix, very, very happy move. Match.com, we highlighted this on the video last night, right? And on the weekend video, Match, 72 needs to build. Put up like a dollar and change move again today, right? Put up a dollar and change move. It went to like 73 and change before coming back in. Shop, I traded Shop. Unfortunately, I only made a third sales and then I got stopped out before it reversed back up to the high. So I made a little bit of money on Shop. 390 sneaky area if it builds, 392 Friday's highs with a measured potential move to 396. Here was Shop. Here was a Shop pivot right here. 390 was right here, right? So 390 was right here, the sneaky pivot. 392 was Friday's highs and 396 that we talked about. Da, 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 da. Look at the high of the day. 396.67. Again, everything goes into formation, the steps. 390, 392 with a measured potential of 396. Da, 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 da. Technical analysis. So that was fine. Netflix again was good. KRTX never obviously got below 63. Netflix 302 needs to build and let's go. I got very excited because again, not, you don't get usually $2-3 moves straight up candles. So that was very, very nice action. So really, really good strong action today across the board. Roku was strong. Roku, Mitch, Netflix, obviously, especially Shop was very strong. So again, business as usual. And again, going into tomorrow, I'm just waiting for the laggards, right? I'm waiting for the stocks, kind of like in the Netflixes, just to kind of wake up. Again, you can't have a rally with, you know, the very, very more aggressive names. And the value that I'm looking for tomorrow, and kind of let's segue into tomorrow's session. Let's start off with Chipotle, right? Again, we're not looking for stocks that are already making moves. We're looking for stocks that are about to confirm a move they made a month ago, right? And if you look at Chipotle, and again, it fits that bill. If they could just start reclaiming, right? If they could start reclaiming this 829, 830 level, I think your first move is like 845, and any close above 845, again, with this type of environment, you could get a move to 880, 890. So I like Chipotle, and I just wish it had more liquidity, but especially for your option players, again, get your ducks in a row. 830 bill can see 845 and then 890 depending strength on the market. I like this Fate, F-A-T-E.
Congratulations for putting in the time to take control of your trading. You're one step closer to owning your future and achieving the success you desire. Want daily trade ideas directly from Dan, straight off his personal watch list? Unlock our free PS60 Vault, where you'll get nightly updates on pivot opportunities we're watching for the next day's session. Click the link in the description to get started today.